Hey guys, welcome back to another shark video, and today we're going to be looking at the shark head, specifically at an issue that popped up, and also we're going to look at the wheels and how they survive so far. So if you guys watched the last video, I did an update on the little wheels at the bottom, and to my amazement, they survived this long, which has been about a month and a half now to this day. Let's look at those first, just for everyone that's curious. And so here you can see the wheels. These are 3D printed wheels that I printed on a 3D printer because the original ones wouldn't last more than about a month. Since I released it about 2 weeks ago, I haven't seen it. So this is how it's basically held up. And as you can see, guys, it's pretty rough. Looks like we have some kind of wind up right there on the front of the roller. And just generally, you know, scuffed up again and things like that. So let's pop this hood open here so we can see a little better what's going on. So as you can see, this stuff catches all kinds of stuff. Looks like we got some kind of little hair band-aid there or something. It doesn't appear that we broke off any more teeth, just those two from last time that I've seen. So that's a plus, I guess. And if we look at the roller here, you can see where the two teeth are broken off, about this area. You do have a minor little bit of a wind up there, as you can see right there. But this is just fluff, basically. It's doing a very, very good job of keeping things from winding up. And as you can see, these little flaps here actually held up okay over time. So it's looking pretty good for it there. So the reason for this video is actually a problem in here. And that is the whatever mechanism that holds this upright. So basically what's going on is this is too loose, this movement here. So whenever you pick up the vacuum, you can see it doesn't hold it at all. It just falls. And if I just vibrate it a little bit, you know, it just falls right down. The issue is that every time you pick up the vacuum, this thing falls down and drags on everything. So just a quick analyzation, I saw there's this crack here in the back and it's splitting open right here for some reason. And as you can see, when I move it, it seems to like get thick, like bigger and smaller. So I think something broke inside of here. So whatever mechanism is keeping this thing, you know, from falling down like that is in that area. So what we're going to do is we're going to take it apart and see if we can find what's going on with it and see maybe what broke in there and if we can even fix it. So just for comparisons, here's a brand new head we haven't used yet. And as you can see, this is how they look like when they're new, and they're very nice. And this mechanism here is very hard for me to even unbuckle like this, because you got to remember that all the leverage you have with the long pole. So it's not supposed to be that easy to unhook. So hopefully we can figure out what's going on with this guy. So unfortunately, Shark decided to go the not so friendly route of actually taking these things apart and repairing them. And the reason for that is because it might be a little hard to see, but they decided to use security screws. So it's like a star security screw, and this is what it kind of looks like. So the screw is a T20 star security. So it has a little hole here in the middle. Mostly this is the tool you need to even take anything apart in this vacuum. So I'm gonna go ahead and take off all these screws underneath. All right, so I took all the little screws out. So some of them were a little bit challenging because they're deep, and the only tool I got is this. So if you have something that's longer than this, obviously it's gonna be much easier. In any case, they all came out and fell out. And so we can see that it's spread. So in order to take off this whole cover, we're gonna have to do some major unassembling. So this thing is kind of put together where it's not like piece by piece here. It's all kind of one component that's all screwed together. But here's the thing that I realized, guys. When I unscrewed it, this piece right here fell out. And this is one of the mounting bolts. To be specific, the one over here on their side, this hole right here, this is where it screws into that screw and it holds this down. So then I realized that what happened was this just broke off of the plastic, and that's why it was spreading. Because right now this thing's not doing anything. It's just falling straight out. So the way this thing works is that the clamp between these two plastics here is what gives it that function. Because if you look at it closer here, as I move it, you can see it goes up and down. So when it gets here, it wants to raise up and then go back down. So technically this would be a good candidate for gluing this together or putting some kind of brace around here behind here that squishes this hard. So and that's probably the direction I'm going to go, because to take this whole thing apart is probably not worth it. It's going to be too complicated, and I'm pretty sure I can stick this thing up in there because I can stretch it enough where I can get in there, as you can see. But now that I'm looking at it, that maybe it's worth it just to go ahead and drill right through the top here because cosmetically I don't really care how it looks, and functionally there's nothing there that goes that way. Drill through all the way down where it comes out the bottom here, and have like a long bolt that goes from here all the way to the bottom that clamps this together. Unfortunately, I don't have too much hardware to work with, but I'm gonna go look around, see what I can find, and we'll go from there. So I didn't have any bolts, but I found a couple screws that I have here. One's a little thicker than the other, and they're about the same length. I think I can make these work, so I'm gonna try to use this. So the first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna drill a hole right through there so it comes out over here. I got my drill bit ready. There we go, that should do it. Hopefully you guys can see we got a hole right there. It's kind of a little bit closer to the edge more than I thought it would be, but I think it'll be all right. So the idea is to run from the top down, but I also need to put in the spacer. But for now, I'm just gonna see if it'll even work. So I'm gonna go ahead and run this thing all the way down and see what we're looking at. All right, so it does go all the way down and it goes out the other hole just a little bit. So I'm gonna go ahead and get everything ready for the glue. But before I do that, I still need to drill out the hole in this little spacer. And that should be perfect. So this is the glue I use. It's called E6000. It's also known as goop, if you can't find this. So this stuff is great, it's super strong, and it bonds the plastic extremely well. And whenever it dries, it becomes like a hard rubber, like a really hard stretchy rubber. So it's gonna be a little bit hard for me to show you guys what I'm doing, but all right guys, so this is what I did. Instead of putting one long screw through there, what I did is I put two screws, still can't see it, but in there is a screw, and then here we got a screw on the top. So we got two screws coming in, and they're both going into that spacer. And that spacer was small enough where these things can screw in them really tight. And then I put a bunch of glue in there, obviously. So we should be good. Now I'm just gonna put all the screws back under here. And then we're gonna have to wait about a day or so until all this glue cures. And then we can try it out and see if it was successful or not. So hopefully this works, and we'll find out here shortly. All right, so it's the next day, and our glue has set up pretty good. As you can see there, it's pretty hard. So it's almost been 24 hours, probably like 22 or so. So I'm thinking that's probably good enough. So I'm gonna go ahead and try it, and hopefully everything will be all right. Let's go ahead. Oh yeah, I can definitely feel that it's tough. There we go. All right, seems to be good. So let's look at it up close, see if there's any flex. So it doesn't appear to be any kind of flex. So I think we got it, guys. So it's finally got a really strong, it's not gonna fall, as you can see. And that problem is definitely eliminated. So maybe this was a little bit of a barbaric fix, you know, with the screw over here. But, you know, for us, this is fine because, you know, this just means we can get more use out of this head. I'm pretty sure if we called Shark and told them that broke, whatever, they'll send us another one. But they've sent us so much stuff, you know, I feel bad calling every time something goes wrong. So if I could fix it and get more life out of it, then that's usually what I try to do. And because we use these Shark vacuums for our cleaning business, if a head like this lasts about 6 months, it's well worth it. Even if we had to change the whole vacuum every half a year, it's still worth it by far compared to, you know, having anything else. And so far the vacuum themselves have been fine. It's just been a few of these little issues. Now this thing breaking could have been, you know, dropped or something, but I don't know, it seems to me that that was just a weak part and it broke. So we've never had this issue happen yet, and we've had a lot of heads like this. So well, the older ones and this new 0M. So, but one thing I will say is that for some reason we've been having a little bit more issues with the newer heads, which is the 0M heads, than the older ones. If you're still debating to, you know, get this or not, I would still recommend this vacuum. At least from our experience, these vacuums just are amazing at what they do. And as you can see, guys, you know, the 0M technology just is awesome. You don't have to do anything. Now you will need to clean out this brush. So as you can see, guys, I already went ahead and cleaned it while I was waiting for the glue to cure. So you do need to kind of clean this area here once in a while, but you know, that's not that big of a deal. All right guys, so I'm pretty happy that I got this fixed. Now I can send this head back to work, and we're gonna continue to see how these little wheels hold up. So here's a little better up close here. Maybe you can see better, but you can see they have not really degraded too much. So it looks like they're gonna go on their 2 month journey here. So I've had a few people ask me if they can get wheels and things like that, or wanting to buy them, and I'm not sure if I should go ahead and just put them for sale or what. But I guess if there's enough people interested in the little printed wheels, then I could put up a little small listing on my website somewhere with a very reasonable price So at least it's worth my time to print them and put them in an envelope to send them to you. Probably, I'm guessing, you know, around $5 for four wheels or something. So I'm gonna see how that works out. If, you know, if there's enough demand, I might do that. But if you guys do need wheels, let me know. And also, if you haven't checked out my other Shark video vacuums, go check those out. I got a bunch of videos on the Apex and the smaller ones and even the earlier ones. So, but our favorite ones are the Apex and now the 0M. So, and if you enjoy videos like this, guys, and you're not subscribed and you want to see more, then hit that subscribe button. And as always, guys, thanks for watching, and I'll see you on the next one. Peace.